for the serious gamer.
Hey, this is Guns for Hire from Next Gen Tactics. This is our challenge series in Team Deathmatch, and this one's called Kill 'Em All. You have to try and get a nuclear bomb with only knife kills and no other kill streaks. Good luck. Class setup is the MP5K with silencer, the Magnum with tactical knife, claymores, flash grenades, Marathon Pro, Lightweight Pro, and Commando Pro. Though the only thing that I'm worried about is the tactical knife and then the perk setting. For kill streaks, only set it to nuke. The challenge is simple. Knife everyone that you can until you get the nuclear bomb. The other team that I'm playing against here are, noobs or whatever it is. Regardless as to whether they're noobs or not, it's particularly on derail. It's a huge map. There's a lot of running. You don't have a lot of time. Noobs or not, I mean, the probability that someone's going to shoot you is still high. And that's why this is a challenge. It doesn't matter whether you're playing against high, level prestige or anything like that. Noobs, whatever. I mean, I don't personally select who I'm playing against. I went in, I play the game, and this is the challenge. I mean, this is what I was setting to do. I came close on Wasteland. I was 21-0, and then someone nailed me. I think it was a sniper. Damn snipers. Anyway, when you're doing this challenge, some tips. Definitely, you're going to need lightweight and marathon. You need to be fast and agile. You need to be able to move quickly. You need that tactical knife. Having your normal melee attack is not going to be sufficient enough for this challenge, because you're going to come across there. I mean, I was lucky there, but you're going to come across situations where there's multiple foes. And if you only have the standard melee attack, you're probably going to end up biting it. You need the quickness of the tactical knife. Now, the other important factor in you being able to actually get a nuclear bomb, only knife attacks, you have to know the maps. I wouldn't recommend this, or you're just going to be frustrated. I mean, go ahead and try, but unless you know the maps and you know where people hide and you know how they access certain areas and you know typically where they come out of, it's going to be very difficult for you to accomplish this. Now, whether you're, derail, the map is sort of irrelevant. There's certain maps, obviously, that are going to be easier than others, and I thought this one was going to be, just me practicing, because, quite frankly, it's a large map, a lot of running, and you don't have a lot of time. This is just straight-up team deathmatch, so there's no, ground war, there's more people to attack, maybe the other games as well. That's part of the challenge. It has to be just straight-up deathmatch. No ground war, no domination or anything like that. Just deathmatch. Makes it a lot harder. But a key in doing this is getting behind and deep into enemy territory. You need to break away from your teammates. That's sort of, the front lines of the battle. You don't want to be there. You want to be deep and behind. That's sort of the ninja type person. The Lone Ranger. You're going in there alone and you don't want to be having all these other people taking kills. Number one, if you're near a teammate and your teammate's blazing the gun, it's going to attract enemies. They're going to know where you are. Whereas in this case here, when you're knifing everyone, the rest of the team has no idea where you are. The only person that knows was the one that you killed. So that's why it's also important that you're not near teammates when you're doing this. Stay away from your teammates. Don't go near them. Stay away from that front line, and always, even if it's switched up, like in this case here, I started on the other end and I forced my way down there, and the team, my team followed, and then eventually they start spawning on this end. So immediately I turn around and I start coming back this way. And that's what you want to do, because basically the enemy is just going to constantly spawn in this area. So as you're knifing them, as the other team, if your teammates are getting throttled, it makes it a little bit more difficult, but they're able to, for whatever reason, even though I think they're a bunch of noobs as well, they're able to sort of hold back, and I think these guys are a little bit nervous because there's some maniac with a knife running around slicing everyone, and just constantly. So, again, make sure you're behind that. You look at the radar. There's my teammates, on the total opposite end of the friggin' map. you do not want to be there. That's not where you're going to get kills. So concentrate on that. If you're looking particularly with Wasteland, those the snipers are going to be looking for you. And though, you know, snipers do look on perimeters, it's a lot easier to run on the perimeter of Wasteland than it is to run through the middle. Because again, you've got those trenches, you got the center in Wasteland that they're looking for. So that's a little tip for that one. It's your only hope is to do perimeter. And I got 21-0, very, very close on that one. There was a couple of prestige people as well. But take the perimeter. That's the only way that I was able to do it. Now, you'll notice if you rewatch it or watch it again, when I'm actually making kills, it's important too, like if you spot someone, I'm running, there's no way that I can sort of battle against anyone that has their sights on me. So a key factor here, and I don't know if I do it necessarily on this one, I have a lot of other knife videos that I could probably show it better on, but if you're running, it's important that you learn evasive maneuvers, which means you run, it's, you know, the football sort of technique, where you're running one way, you fake them out, you dodge one way, and then you swing around the back area there. It's very important that you do that, especially when you notice someone with a gun that's sort of gunning for you. It's your only way that you're going to survive. You have to trick them, you have to fake them out. Now here, we have radar, so what I'm doing is I'm taking a quick look at the map to see where they're going. I noticed they're on the far field, and this is where knowing the maps is helpful. Because I know my teammates are at the other end, and I can see that all the red guys are on the far end, on the other side there. Typically, you only access that area. That's a transition or a run area. No one stays in that area. So they're running to one end or the other, and obviously, I would say that they're running this area here. Oh, very, very lucky on that one. I could hear them, though. If you don't have a surround sound headset like a Turtle Beach, mine's not a Turtle Beach, mine's a Triton AX Pro, it does make it a little more difficult too. You need to be constantly listening. It doesn't, you know, not everyone's going to have Ninja on, so having that ability to sort of focus, you know, and locate people based on sound is critical in this as well. I mean, if you just hear people stepping around, and you're just going and running around hoping you're going to knife them, you're going to increase the probability that you're going to die. So having surround sound does help, but that doesn't mean that you're not going to be able to do the challenge. It just means that it's going to be a little more difficult. Now I'm starting to get a little bit more cautious because I'm getting close to the challenge, the nuke part here. But the other part that I'm trying to sort of avoid, and these guys are following me like little lost puppy dogs, like this guy behind me, I'm trying to friggin' lose him, but he's just constantly hanging around me, and it's actually really annoying, because that guy's gonna draw attention. He's just running around, who knows when he's gonna blast his friggin' guns off, and then he's gonna give my position away. So he sort of back off, let him do his own thing, maybe he'll get killed, and I won't have to really worry about it. And now this is the critical moment. I know this door is a huge entry point, and basically, I camp it out until I get the final kill right there, and then I die and I don't really care. Normally I would continue going on and on and on, but the challenge was nuclear bomb after knife kill. I attained it, and I don't care, it's time to friggin' cook everyone. It was a hard challenge, noobs or not, it is not an easy challenge to do. But I'm sure there are people out there that will be able to do it and are up for the challenge. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. Watch for more challenge videos that we'll be putting out on Modern Warfare 2. For other strategies and tactics on Modern Warfare 2, visit nextgentactics.com. Thanks for watching.